Clearly, we need to consult an expert on this. So we went to NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Maryland to talk to Alex Young, a NASA scientist, and ask for his best explanation.
To try to make it as simple as possible, it really boils down to how fast the Earth is spinning and how fast the Moon is orbiting around it. The Moon is orbiting about twice as fast as the Earth is spinning. The Moon is orbiting about twice as fast as the Earth is spinning.
Now, this isn't the main thrust of this video, but all of you who want to be brain dead for whatever reason, here you have a high-level scientist from NASA, Goddard Space Center in Maryland, tell you directly that the Moon is orbiting twice as fast as the Earth is spinning. The Moon is moving twice as fast as the Earth is spinning. Correct? Isn't that what he just said? That means, think about this, that means the Moon should rise and set 2 times for every time the Sun rises and sets. It's moving twice as fast as the Earth is spinning. Right? It's orbiting twice as fast. That means you would, whenever you see the Moon in the sky, it should be moving twice as fast across the sky as the Sun. What causes the Sun to move across the sky according to their model? The speed of the rotation of the Earth. So if the Moon is going twice as fast as that, then it should loop the Sun. It should lap the Sun, I should say. It should lap the Sun once every day. There's no way around this, people. This is what he's telling you. Why is he telling you this? Because this is the only way to explain the eclipse. It's the only way to explain why the shadow moves from west to east. The Moon has to move twice as fast as the Earth spins.